So let's start off with today's afternoon session, the global practices to deliver cinema to an international audience. And our session sponsor is New York VFXWAALA. Post-production technology, global practices to deliver cinema to an international audience. Session sponsor, once again, NYVFXWAALA, the VFX people, Mumbai. Now we'll be playing a short video. So please put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. A huge round of applause for NYVFXWAALA and the video. Cinema tastes worldwide are inching towards a standardized quality of viewing. With cinema goers, even in India, Tier 2 and Tier 3 getting to watch top Hollywood releases, the ball is in the court of Indian production houses to ensure quality of production in homegrown content. At the heart of this lies the technological advancements and latest softwares in post-production processing. The discussion will introduce audience to global practices of post-production, importing talent and exporting content for an international audience. So I would like to invite onto the dais Mr. C.V. Rao, Mr. Naveen Paul, Mr. Dharmendra Kakarala, and Mr. Shivakumar, BVR. A huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. C.V. Rao is the General Manager, Post-Production, Annapurna Studios. Mr. Naveen Paul is the Co-Founder and VFX Supervisor, NYVFXWAALA. Mr. Dharmendra Kakarala, National Award Film Editor, worked for movies Prasthanam, Chandamama Kadalu. And Mr. Shivakumar, BVR, Colorist, worked for Nani, Magadira, Bahubali, Drishyam in Malayalam. Huge round of applause. And now I hand over the mic to Mr. C.V. Rao, who will be moderating this discussion.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is C.V. Rao. I am from Annapurna Studios. I work as a general manager for the post-production. And I am into this field since last 18 years. Career started as a DTP operator and worked as a 3D animator, editor, and VFX, and finally I'm heading the post-production in Annapurna Studios. I'm happy to be here and happy to share the dais with Mr. Naveen and Dharmendra and Shivakumar. And let us welcome the panel members, Mr. Naveen, and I would like to request Naveen to brief about his journey.
My name is Naveen Paul. I'm the co-founder and VFX supervisor for NYVFXWAALA. We started off in 2015. It's been 2.5 years now, and we have been consecutively winning the best VFX and CJ house in India. We were also the National Award recipient last year. We were Asian Award recipient last year. So it's been a great journey, and we hope to give you more excellent visuals moving forward in the coming projects. Thank you.
Now I request Dharmendra, editor.
I'm Dharmendra Kakarala, film editor. I am a pass out from Sachitre Film and Television Institute in 2003. Then I edited my first film, Prasthanam, in 2010. Which was selected for Indian Panorama, and I got a critical acclaim for that. and I have worked on 20 films from then. In 2015, one of my film got a national award for the best regional Telugu. And today, I'm here for discussing the production things.
Now, Shivakumar, he is the colorist for Bahubali and he has done many films in his earlier. Shivakumar.
Thank you, Sirigaru. This is my first talk show. I think I will talk level my best. Actually, I have done my commerce degree, but I wanted to work in films, but I don't know how to come to work in films. So
he is very passionate guy, and he tried. It's hard to come to the film industry. He worked as a DVD author. He started his career as a DVD author, and moved into digital optical department when there was a negative. Then he started his grading job with a film called Arundhati, which was a huge hit and technically got very good name. And he has done Makki, I think Makki, Nani, and in Telugu, Iga. And after that, he has done Bahubali two parts, the beginning and the conclusion. And we'll move on to discussion, actual discussion. The discussion is about like post-production technology, global practices for the movie to deliver to an international audience. The post-production technology is in a very important stage for any film, any feature film. And this is the stage where the real magic happens. And this is where the actual, like the production puzzle will come together for creating a finished product. And in the post-production, the actual post-production starts the moment you start the shooting. It starts from the day you shoot and store the data and how you take the offline and send it to edit room. From there, the editor will start looking at the shots, then he will start doing the work by interacting with the director, and the actual process starts there. Now I request editor Dharmendra to share something about the editing, how it is happening today, how it was earlier, and how it is going forward with the latest technology.
When I went to film school in 2001, the film, the editing, the shooting was on films, it's not on digital. So the thing is, we used to edit manually. In film school also, we learned the process of editing, digitizing the film footage and editing on Avid. And at the same time, we were taught how the manual editing goes on. Luckily, we are in, at the time, it is a phase of shifting the film to the digital. So the most of the films were shot on film, and some films were shot on digital in around 2004-2005. So in the film school, after the pass out of film school, when I come here, the manual editing was going on still in Hyderabad, and most of the big films were working on Avid, and the smaller films were working on manual things. So I have edited, I have worked as an assistant editor with prominent editors who are already working in the mainline cinema. So I was into both, like manual and then on Avid also. So I used to assist them, I used to work on Avid and take the cut list and then even sit with the negative cutter and supervise the things which were going in with the negative. But by the time I come, my first film was edited, that was in 2010, and almost it was the last but one film which will be shot on film in Hyderabad. So my first film was shot on film, but it was released digitally and even in prints. That is the last but one film almost in Hyderabad. And the post was done with the technical head was CV Rao. So that is that way we are connected.
That's where the actual digital started actually. So yeah. When we were doing Prasthanam, the digital was just starting about it. The technology, like it was in a HD camera, the Panasonic HD camera came into the market. But that was not enough to deliver the cinema quality those days. That's the reason they went on shooting on the negative. Then we have converted negative into digital, then DI. The DI was not that popular, they just started even that one. So that's how it started.
Yeah. So the film is converted into digital, they color correct it, again they record it onto the negative, and then the main negative will be sent to the married print. That is the process which used to go in 2010, which when my first film was edited. And one thing I want to tell is, while we are editing now, the shoot goes in digital, we will get a low-res footage for editing, and we edit it, we give the output for reference, and they take the raw footage and match the reference which is in low-res, and then they go for the color correction. That is the process which is easier now, very simple looking process. But now the main important thing is the digital should be looking like a film. Where now I think the main important part was with the color correction here when it is coming to the digital part. Whereas in the film, I think most of the depth and all can be created in the film itself, in the lighting of the film and all. But in the digital, they were using lesser lights, and the depth part and the color part is taken care of later in the color correction. So,
Dharmendra garu, so the moment you get the rush from the client or from the director, how you start looking at the footage, how you start editing it, can you explain it better?
See, editing. I think editing is the third time writing the script for me. It is the third and the final time writing the script. The director writes the script before the pre-production, and they get into pre-production, they plan according to the script, they shoot it. And again now, with the footage, I have to write the script on the editing table. So writing means doesn't mean that it literally I am writing. I have to write with the shots. I have to rewrite the scenes which were taken, which were shot according to the scene. So I have to follow the script and I edit it according to the script. And I will show my perspective, how it can be presented to the audience.
Okay, thank you. Do you have any questions on this particular topic? I think it will be more interactive if you raise the questions. Otherwise, it will be only one side.
Actually, sir, there is one rumor that whatever the footage brought by cameraman on the sets will not be seen by editor, and editor cutting of footage is based on his mood or something else.
I didn't get you.
See, what is point? Can I?
Yeah.
What is point is, whatever the shots taken in the location, it won't be reviewed by the editor. That was his question. Is that true?
See, frankly speaking, that depends on the editor, how much time he's spending on his research, and how many films he's working. It's a personal question actually. If it comes to me, I can deal only two films at a time. So when I'm dealing two films at a time, I can watch the whole rush, every single shot which was shot by the director. When the scene order is placed, I will watch the whole rush. I will sit on it, I will go through it, each and every shot, and then I edit. That is my style. I don't want to comment on other editors, but if they are working on 6 to 7 films in a year or at a time, there are editors who are working 10 films at a time. I don't think they get a time to even edit the scenes, even edit the first cut. So they come in the final stage of editing, and they start their work from the dubbing part, or after dubbing or before dubbing. But myself, I work two films at a time, maximum three. More than that, I can't work because I even sit for the sound. Because while editing, I think about the sound also.
Yeah, actually, I want to point out something else. Earlier, once I had a discussion of Sri Mata and Venkatesh. Approximate what he said exactly, but I can't replay now. But from his words, I understood that he, first of all, whatever the footage he comes to him. He, without getting a narration from anyone, he watches that footage and he takes his own decision and confront the same with director and producer and make it final. So how you
I know what he said actually. That is his style. He doesn't want any script or anything else. He will see the rush order and then start editing itself. So that is his style actually. Every person has his own style of working. But I follow the traditional style of working.
It always depends on the technician. How much of time they have to spend, they want to spend on the project, and how much of importance they have to give to the project. So if they want to be involved completely for one film, yes, they have to start from the script reading. Once they read the script, then they will understand what is the director is taking on the location. If they don't read it, they won't know until they see the rush. So if they didn't read the script, they see only rush. So after seeing the rush, they will understand what has been taken, and only those rush will be edited. And once he edit the rush, and once he edit the scene, then he will come to know what shots I need for further betterments. Until then, he will not know.
Friends, can I ask some more question? So actually, how long it takes from getting footage to giving some complete copy, edited copy to the producer or director?
Yeah, time depends on the film actually. For Chandmama Kadalu, I took 3 months of total editing. But the recent film I did was Garuda Vega, which it took 1 year for editing. Because the sequences, it depends on the sequences and the storyline actually.
Any more questions?
I don't think that much of time is applicable for all the directors or producers. Is it possible to do editing in 1 week or 2 weeks or month itself?
For a film?
Yeah, for a film.
That is what I'm telling. It depends on the story. If you take Guntur Talkies, I edited Guntur Talkies in last year. I have edited the first cut in 8 days. It went to dubbing and then it came back to me within a week. And I have done the final cut within 6 days. First half 3 days and the second half 3 days. Which will come under totally, if you take, including dubbing if you take, it comes under 20 days. It depends on the film. For Garuda Vega, I need a lot of time because the action sequences which were involved in it. I took a lot of time to edit. I took around 2000 hours, more than 2000 hours. And 185 to 200 days to work on it.
So any more questions?
Do you get that full copy rushes or part by part? Like you said, Garuda Vega, you took 1 year, but
the rushes will be coming according to the schedule, shooting schedule. They plan it.
Okay.
They plan something in November, December, January. By the end of the shoot, I'll be getting some parts. If the shoot starts in November, then the November part I'll be getting it will be according to the plan actually. If there is a 10-day schedule, I'll get after the 6th or 7th day, I'll start getting the rushes. Then I have to order it and to start edit, it'll take 2 days or 4 days after I get the rush. So it depends on the shooting plan. The whole structure, we have to plan it accordingly. We have to plan according to the shoot dates and how you are scheduling it, when the director will be free, and when I can show the director the edited scenes and all. Yeah.
Okay, one more important element in the post-production is visual effects. Nowadays, visual effects are very popular and every movie has minimal VFX, starting like 1 minute, 200 minutes or full film. The visual effects team will be involved from the day they start scripting. They are getting involved. So if you see 10 years ago, we had very limited talent in India, and today there is a lot of talent in India to deliver the international quality. And our Indian team, Indian talent is doing, not only doing regional and national, and they are also capable of doing international films. Now I request Naveen to share his journey. They have been doing many films in India and abroad also. Naveen, please.
As
my question is involved, like how you get involved from the scripting stage, then production stage, then post-production stage.
Okay.
Yeah. Storyboarding from the storyboard.
Yeah, so I think the more VFX is basically the growth of VFX industry in India has been exponentially larger than any other industry in filmmaking, I would say. I don't know if you would accept that, but the use of visual effects in film has been tremendously increasing over the past few years. And today's time, we have reached to a point where stories are being told using visual effects as a great support to storytelling. So technically, we have grown, aesthetically we have grown, and the VFX industry has been continuously been evolving with time, the usage of VFX in storytelling, the number of the institutes, the filmmaking institutes are doing tremendously good teaching VFX for the students.
So after visual effects, I think we have expected few from the sound department, but unfortunately they are caught busy on their own works. And after visual effects, DI is the most crucial element for any future film. Earlier, when there was a negative, they used to shot the entire film on the negative, then the negative has to go to laboratory for the developing. And after developing, only you can see the visual, like through the telecine, it comes to the edit, then you start editing. But in today technology, it's only digital, there is no film. Okay, once you shoot digital, then will you be able to edit that raw footage directly in the editing software like Final Cut Pro and Avid? You cannot. If you have high-end hardware, you can start editing in the Avid or FCP, but most of the time, they have to down-convert the high-resolution footage, maybe 4K or 6K, 8K. Now there is 8K also available with Red Helium. To make it a smooth editing pipeline, you have to down convert the footage to the Apple ProRes 422 or 422 LT or MXF files, then it will go to editing room. So that is the, after shooting, that's how you get the footage to the editing room. Then edit happens, then visual effects also joins there, visual effect joining from the scripting stage, that will come later part. And after editing, what happens? After editing, then the footage will go to dubbing, as you all know. So dubbing also is very important element in the post-production stage, where you have to get the clear voice and as per the artist, which will be suitable, and you have to find the right artist, dubbing artist. And once that is being done, then it will come back to editor, where he will do the final trimming. The trimmed video will go to the DI. DI means digital intermediate, where you have to give the color treatment and you have to create the mood for the scene to the entire film. And the DI, the colorist plays major role to create the looks for the entire film. And where DOP and colorist, they sit together and they discuss and the DI room where you can use base light and DaVinci Resolve and Quantel Pablo is there. And the display projectors like Barco is there and Christie is there. And also a very important element is the calibration. The color calibration is very important. You may do the grading in the monitor using the monitor or using the display projector. What you see on the monitor or projector, it has to be reproduced in the theaters. That is most important element. So in Bahubali 1, there is one scene where Ramakrishna carrying the kid in the opening scene. How it's been shot, how you have seen the input when it comes to DI, and what is the output, what is the process, what was the process has been done?
Ramakrishna sequence, actually day for night sequence. Day lo shoot chesaru. So actually night scene prakaram night ga convert cheyali. But vallu ichina time vachesi early morning undali. So details teliyali, sky lo details undali, face lo expressions teliyali. So dani kosam ekkuva deep pokurdu, ekkuva bright pokurdu, chaala limitations pettaru. So shot chesetappudu chaala limitations undevi. So dani kosam mem gray color vellala lekante blue color velthe routine telugu films laga routine indian films laga untadi ala kaakunda oka hollywood movie look teeskravali ante typical color tone man select cheskovali so dan tone kosam mem chaala r&d chesam so a tone velthe baaguntadi a tone velthe apt ga untadi a tone velthe clear details blacks lo gaani whites lo gaani details untayi ekkada crush avukunda లో లైట్లో కూడా అంటే కొన్ని థియేటర్స్లో ప్రొజెక్టర్స్లో చాలా లో లైట్లో ప్రొజెక్ట్ చేస్తుంటారు సో అప్పుడు కూడా డీటెయిల్స్ తెలియాలంటే ఏ డెన్సిటీలో ఏ కలర్లో ఏ ప్యాలెట్లో వెళ్తే బాగుంటుందని మేము చాలా ఆర్ఎండి చేసాం దాన్ని చేసేదానికే దాదాపు ఒక 3-4 నెలలు చేసాం దానికి ఆర్ఎండి సో టోటల్ ఫిల్మ్స్ మేము 8 నెలలు గ్రేడ్ చేసాం సో 8 నెలల్లో దాదాపు 7 మంత్స్ మేము టోన్స్ ఏ టోన్ వెళ్ళాలి అనే దానికే టైం స్పెండ్ చేసాం గ్రేడింగ్ చేసింది లాస్ట్ 1 మంతే సో ఈ అలాంటి టోన్స్ సెలెక్ట్ చేసి పెట్టుకొని సీజీ లాస్ట్ మినిట్లోనే వచ్చాయి మాకు ఒక్కొక్క సీజీ ఒక్కొక్క టైం పీరియడ్లో వస్తుంది దాని క్వాలిటీ చెక్ చేసుకోవడానికి వాటికి సరిపోతుంది సో అలా ఒక్కొక్క టోన్ని మేము సెలెక్ట్ చేసుకుంటూ గ్రేడ్ చేయాల్సి వచ్చింది అది
షో వాట్ ఈస్ ద బేసిక్ ఎలిమెంట్ టు స్టార్ట్ ద గ్రేడింగ్ సో వాట్ డూ యూ సీ హౌ డూ యూ స్టార్ట్ హూమ్ డూ యూ ఇంటరాక్ట్
గ్రేడ్ చేయాలంటే ఫస్ట్ మూవీ యొక్క కంటెంట్ అసలు ఏంటి అసలు మూవీ ఏ కంటెంట్లో చేస్తున్నారు సో ఆ మూడ్ ఏంటి దానికి ఏ ప్యాలెట్ అయితే అవసరం అనేది ఫస్ట్ డిఓపితో డిస్కస్ చేయాలి సో డిస్కస్ చేసిన తర్వాత సో ప్యాలెట్ అసలు ఏ ప్యాలెట్లో వెళ్తున్నాం సో దాంట్లో ఎన్ని వేరియేషన్స్ ఉన్నాయి సో ఏ వేరియేషన్స్కి వెళ్ళాలంటే ఎలా 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 మనం ముందే ఫిక్స్ చేసుకోవాలని షూటింగ్కి ముందే కొంతమంది డిఓపీలు డిస్కస్ చేస్తారు సో కొంతమంది తర్వాత కూడా వస్తుంది సో దేదానికి ముందే షూట్ చేసే పట్టి దాని అకార్డింగ్ టు దట్ వాటి షూట్ చేస్తారు అలా కాకుండా షూట్ చేసిన వచ్చిన వాటికి అయితే సో వచ్చిన వాటిలో ఏది బెస్ట్ సో దానికి టోన్స్ రెఫరెన్సెస్ కానీ ఉంటుంది సో స్టోరీ విన్న తర్వాత ఎడిట్లో కూడా చూసిన తర్వాత 1 or 2 hours అక్కడ మూవీ చూసి డిస్కస్ చేసుకొని తర్వాత గ్రేడ్ స్టార్ట్ చేస్తాం చేసిన తర్వాత అసలు ఏమనుకొని డిఓపి షూట్ చేశాడు సో అతని మైండ్లో విజువల్ ఎట్లా ఉంది ఏ టోన్స్ పెట్టుకొని ఏ రెఫరెన్సెస్ పెట్టుకొని షూట్ చేశాడో అది తెలుసుకొని అతని మైండ్లో ఉన్న కలర్స్ని మనం స్క్రీన్ మీద రిఫ్లెక్ట్ చేయాలి సో ఇది చేయాలంటే డిఓపిని అనలైజ్ చేయాలి సో స్టోరీ గురించి కానీ అతని దానికి ప్యాలెట్ అతని ఎందుకు సెలెక్ట్ చేసుకున్నాడు దానికి ఏం రెఫరెన్సెస్ తీసుకున్నాడు అవన్నీ తెలుసుకొని చేయాలి సో ఈ ప్రాసెస్లో టోన్స్ కానీ అవన్నీ ఉంటాయి
షో ఐ థింక్ యు హావ్ బీన్ వర్కింగ్ యాజ్ ఎ కలరిస్ట్ సిన్స్ మెనీ ఇయర్స్ అండ్ యు హావ్ సీన్ ద టెక్నాలజీ చేంజ్ వాట్ వాజ్ యువర్ ఫస్ట్ ఫిలిం అండ్ హౌ ఇట్ వాజ్ షార్ట్ అండ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద కరెంట్ టెక్నాలజీ యు ఆర్ యూజింగ్ అండ్ హౌ యు ఆర్ సీయింగ్ టుడే అండ్ వాట్ వాజ్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ యు హావ్ సీన్
నేను డేటా ఎంట్రీగా నా కెరీర్ స్టార్ట్ చేశాను 1997 అంటే 20 ఇయర్స్ 2017
ఐ రిపీట్ ద క్వశ్చన్ సి వెన్ యూ స్టార్ట్ యువర్ ఫస్ట్ ఫిల్మ్ ఓకే వాట్ వాజ్ ద కెమెరా అండ్ వాట్ వాజ్ ద ఫుటేజ్ యూ హ్యావ్ రిసీవ్డ్ అండ్ వాట్ వాజ్ ద టెక్నాలజీ అండ్ వాట్ వాజ్ ద స్కానర్స్ అండ్ వాట్ వాజ్ ద సాఫ్ట్వేర్ యూ యూస్డ్ అండ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ యూ హ్యావ్ సీన్ ఫ్రమ్ దేర్ టు హియర్ కెన్ యూ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్
నా ఫస్ట్ ఫిల్మ్ అభియుమ్నానం తమిళ్లో అభియుమ్నానం అనే ఫిల్మ్ ఫస్ట్ ఫ్యూజులో షూట్ చేశాడు దాన్ని. చేసిన తర్వాత దాన్ని లస్టర్లో నేను గ్రేడ్ చేశాను. సో నాకు దాంట్లో మేజర్ చేంజెస్ ఏంటంటే, మేజర్ ఛాలెంజింగ్ ఏంటంటే, కొంచెం పాటు వచ్చేసి కులుమనాలి షూట్ చేశారు, కొంచెం పాటు వచ్చేసి ఊటీలో షూట్ చేశారు. సో నా రెండింటిని డిఫరెన్స్ తెలియకుండా ఆ గ్రీన్స్ని కంట్రోల్ చేయాలి, అంటే సేమ్ సిమిలర్ టోన్ తీసుకురావాలి. సో దానికి నాకు లస్టర్ చాలా ఉపయోగపడింది. సో డిజిటల్లో చేసిన, డిజిటల్లో ఇప్పుడు డిజిటల్ రెవల్యూషన్లో లస్టర్ పోయింది కానీ, సో అనలాగ్ ఫిల్మ్స్ నెగిటివ్లో స్కాన్ చేసిన ఫిల్మ్స్ని లస్టర్ బాగా హ్యాండిల్ చేస్తుంది. నాకు నచ్చిన వాటిలో లస్టర్ ది బెస్ట్. సో అనలాగ్ నెగిటివ్ స్కాన్స్లో నాకు చాలా బెస్ట్. సో నెగిటివ్ వచ్చిన తర్వాత దాన్ని ఆక్స్బరీ స్కాన్లో 4Kలో స్కాన్ చేశారు. 4K చేసి 4K నుంచి 2K డౌన్ సైజ్ చేసిన తర్వాత దాన్ని కలర్ గ్రేడింగ్ చేయడం జరిగింది అది. సో ఇప్పుడు వచ్చే దాని తర్వాత లస్టర్ తర్వాత నేను 4-5 టూల్స్లో పనిచేశాను. ఒకటి మిస్టికా, లస్టర్, స్క్రాచ్, రిజాల్వ్ అండ్ బేస్ లైట్. సో ఈ నాలుగింటిలో ఒక్కొక్క దానికి ఒక్కొక్క స్పెషాలిటీ ఉంటుంది. సో ఇప్పుడు బేస్ లైట్లో వచ్చేసి ఉన్న స్పెషాలిటీ ఏంటంటే, నేను సీజీ బేస్ నుంచి వచ్చాను కాబట్టి నేను ఏం చేయగలనో, సో మొత్తం సీజీ వాళ్ళు ఇచ్చిన దానికంటే ఎక్కువ నేను ఏమైనా చేయగలగాలంటే నేను సీజీ వాళ్ళ మీద డిపెండ్ అవ్వకుండా నేనే చేసుకోవచ్చు. సో అంత కంపాటబిలిటీ బేస్ లైట్లో ఉంటుంది. సో ఏమైనా నాకు క్రియేషన్ కావాలంటే, ఏమైనా సీజీ ఎలిమెంట్స్ని యాడ్ చేసుకోవాలంటే నేనే చేసుకోవచ్చు.